This morning found the prisoners in a more subdued, less defiant mood, their hoods and torn blankets replaced by noticeably smarter clothes. But 9 o'clock came and went, and fears grew of last-minute snags in the plan for a peaceful end to the trouble. There were, it seemed, some differences over which door the prisoners should go through, but they were soon sorted out, and minutes later, the surrender began. They moved through the barricades only 5 at a time, so they could, according to a Home Office spokesman, be processed. He refused to say what processing meant, but explained it was a slow and careful business. Strangely, the numbers on the rooftop grew at first, the men apparently savouring the last few moments of a kind of freedom. A holiday atmosphere developed in the warm sunshine. Pop music from a loudspeaker trickled across the rooftop and down to the street below. Cigarettes and jugs of tea were passed around. After processing, some of the men, many handcuffed together, were taken out of the back entrance to join teams of warders in waiting coaches. And there were cheers from the few colleagues still waiting their turn as the convoy set off with police escort, bound for somewhere rather less exotic than the word Paris on the destination board of one of the coaches might have suggested. The loss of a year's remission and a spell in solitary confinement seem the likely penalties for the men who took part in Britain's worst prison riot since the 1930 Dartmoor Mutiny.